Hey Isopod friends, this is Jay Asuncion, and today we will start a new video series called Gotta Collect 'Em All. We will focus on one species, we will discuss all its color morph or different locales. No classification, no care video, just plain old Isopod morph tournament pageant. Let's start! This is my Porcillo Laevis Isopod collection. I have a total of 9 Sterilite containers just for Porcillo Laevis. Sizes are from 15 quarts up to 32 quarts. Now let's set up some rules on this Isopod tournament. First, isopods in my collections are isopods that are for sale or available in United States only. And number two, new morphs or new locales introduced after this date won't be included in my video. We'll start with Porcillo Laevis wild type. So this is my enclosure. I purchased the isopod from Smugbug because I can't find any Laevis in my backyard. All I can find are Armadillidium vulgare, Oniscus acellus, and Porcillo scaber, wild types, but no Laevis. Wild type means it's in their natural color or form, and what's found in nature, or outside in our case. Looking at my enclosure, I have a moist side and a dry side with lots of ventilation. Looks like we could only find 2, so let's magnify. The wild type is dark brown in appearance to camouflage with their environment. It's a defense mechanism. The dorsal surface is smooth and glossy. Actually, all Porcillo Laevis have this characteristic. If you look closer, they have a pattern in their perion. It's a yellowish tint. Again, this is a defense mechanism to better camouflage in nature. They are voracious eaters, which makes them a good cleanup crew. I would not recommend that you go out and get Porcillo Laevis. As a cleanup crew, they may carry parasites or hitchhikers. I would recommend that you buy them from a breeder. Now let's talk about color morphs. What is a color morph? First, let's dissect the word morph. It came from the word metamorphosis, which is a Greek word meaning a transformation. A color morph is some sort of genetic mutation that occurred that makes an organism look different than what is commonly expected. A morph is different from a genetic defect where it generally affects color, hence the name color morph, rather than a physical makeup like a missing antenna. To recap, morph is a variation in color in the same species which occurred because of selective breeding. So why does the hobby likes color morph? First, they rarely occur in nature. Second, they're cute. And lastly, they're collectibles. Without any further delay, let's jump on the first morph, the dairy cow. Also, let me point out that cute little sticker. Dairy cow is the most popular of all the Laevis morph. If you're into isopod, you probably have this in your collection. So they call this morph Dalmatian in Europe. Well, they look like a dairy cow. They have a white body with black spots. they are very easy isopods to take care of, like beginner level. Yes, they're almost a bulletproof isopod. If you miss them once a week and give them food, they will thrive. And yes, they are fast breeders. This is one of my earliest isopod. I remember the feeling when I first saw them having babies on Mankai's. I was very happy. Porcelia laevis in general are not seasonal breeders. They breed year-round. The size is up to 20 millimeters. It's like 0.787 of an inch, so they're smaller than an inch. With that being said, with their size, they make up for it with its activity. Unlike most isopod, which is nocturnal, Porcelia laevis is diurnal, meaning they're active during the daytime. That's why most people say they're very active. This is true to all the Porcelia laevis morphs. They're mostly used as a cleanup crew, but if you have a reptile that is very fast, make sure you have a separate culture that's not with the reptile, so they can bounce back with their population. The Irkow is probably the most underrated isopod in the hobby. Orange morph. First, let me show you my orange sticker and my rainbow sticker that I got this during Pride Month, and a little note from the seller from eBay. Orange mutation is the most common mutation in isopod. This is not the albino form, it's just an orange mutation. The first orange mutation was isolated in Porcelia scaber, and this is what propelled the isopod hobby to what we know now, like collecting all these color morphs. Isopods were used before as a cleanup crew, now they're collected because of their different morphs. And they're actually elevated now to a pet status. The orange morph also has that pattern like the wild type. The orange mutation occurs in a lot of species in isopod, like Porcelia scaber, Armadillidium vulgare, orange viger, Armadillidium werneri orange, Porcelionidis brunoceus powder orange, Oniscus acellus BC maple, and Porcelia expansus, which is really expensive. Now let's go to the milkback morph. Milkback is the second most popular morph of laevis. It's characterized by the predominantly gray or dark brown coloration with a splash of white that looks like a spilled milk. I don't know if you've noticed that most of my culture are pretty new, except the dairy cow, which I have this since summer of 2019. You can see that they already have babies or mankais. Laevis and all the morphs are fast breeders. You will see your culture reproducing within 2 to 3 months. That's why it's a very popular species, especially with beginners. One good thing about Porcelia laevis is they're very forgiving. They will even tolerate high humidity or even wet condition in some degree. That's why I said earlier that this is almost a bulletproof isopod. White Morph. This was given to me by my friend David Ferrelli, and that sticker was from him too. The benefits of having friends in a hobby are, instead of buying isopod, you can always trade with them. You can also get isopods that you already have to improve your gene pool. And if your culture crash in the future, you can ask them to spare you some. It's like an insurance policy, if you're just sharing without buying. Especially if the isopods are very expensive, I would recommend that you have a trusted friend as a backup. This white mutation or albino has a white body or cream sometimes, with black freckles but not a large dots of color black like in the dairy cow. Albino isopods are very sensitive to light. That's why when you first expose them, they run right away. I like this morph a lot. It's really cool that you can see what they digested with this dark line here. So this is not a spine. Isopods are invertebrates. They do not have spine or internal skeleton. This is their digestive tract. Some hobbyists claim that if you feed them carrot, this would be orange. I think that's really cool. You can see this in orange morph too. The average lifespan of Porcelio laevis is around 12 to 18 months, less than 2 years. One good thing about isopod as a cleanup crew is, once you buy them, they will continue to reproduce. As compared to a saltwater aquarium like what I have, you constantly have to replenish the cleanup crew when they die because they do not reproduce in captivity. I don't know if you're as old as me, but this next morph reminded me of the early 2000s song called "Yeah, Caramel, get 'em all the time, hot as shit, city high." Caramel morph. Some breeders claim that this morph is a cross between the orange and the wild type. The coloration of this one is creamy brown caramel. I actually have to isolate the isopod, put it in a container, and go outside with the natural light for this one. When I shot the footage last night with a regular indoor incandescent light, it looks like a wild type. But in a natural light, the color of this one is caramel. Speaking of the wild type, Porcelio laevis was first recorded in the late 13th century in Britain, even before Latrell classified it in 1804. It was believed that this isopod originated in North Africa. It's found all over the world now by accidental distribution through agriculture. Porcelio laevis and all of its morph can easily be sexed. The males are identified by their long speared shaped uropods. Brown cow. Yep, that's the brown cow sticker. I purchased this from Laura of Smugbug. Everyone who's into serious isopod collection knows Smugbug. This lady has a variety of isopod and she has good prices too. I think she's the only one in United States right now that's selling this. She calls this How Now, which is derived from a popular nursery rhyme, How Now Brown Cow. I just call this brown cow because I'm having tongue twist pronouncing How Now Brown Cow. I also like brown cow. It has that wink to the other morph, dairy cow. Per Lore's website, this mutation is similar to the dairy cow with brown spots instead of the black spots. She also said this was isolated out of the caramel morph. I really like the brown freckles or dots all over its body. Yes, there's no black markings at all, just brown spots. You can also see their digestive tract, which I think it's cool. The difference between the brown cow and the white albino has black dots, while the brown cow has brown dots. So this is the newest morph that's out in the market right now. It's just a little pricey because it's a new morph, but they probably will go down in price because they're fast breeders. So far, this is my favorite morph. They are really beautiful, especially up close. Remember I mentioned that color morph is a variation in color within the same species, which is a product of selective breeding. What if an organism got separated from the other population due to geographic boundaries and they develop variation from the original population? So we call that bilocal or locality. Aside from the color variation, sometimes they will exhibit changes within their size, maybe due to the food or diet that is available to them in their new environment. Priscilla Lavis has one locale as of now, and it's called California Mix. So this is how Priscilla Lavis looks naturally in California. This is not a mixture of all the morphs, like we discussed earlier. They just come in a variety of colors. Maybe you can make a morph out of this mix. It's like the tangerine morph is from the Vulgari Punta Cana locale. This locale is also called marbled or orange and white. This California mix has a variety of colors, like white, gray, of course orange, ombre, and even a milk bag. I'm sure that there will be a morph that will come out of this in the future. Actually, some breeders claim that the caramel morph came from this locale. This California mix is a gift from my breeder friend, David Ferrelli. As you notice, he gave this to me this June, and after 2 months, they're already reproducing. Please note, he gave me adults isopod. So what I meant is, they can quickly establish in your enclosure. And I also got my video presentation idea from him. He mentioned it to me that collecting isopod is like collecting Pokemon from his childhood TV show. So I came up with that theme. So what is your favorite morph out of the 7 we discuss? Are you planning to collect them all? Do you think you can create a new morph from the California mix? If you like anything in this video, please like, comment, or subscribe. It helps my channel a lot. And hopefully I can do more of this video that just focus on color morph or locales. Thank you so much, isopod friends. I enjoyed doing this video.